Hello, this is Dread, and in today's video topic, we're going to be talking about 0.9 and potential season starters. The first thing I want to point out is this is based on the knowledge I gained through playing the game on the Crash the Server Party event we had a few weeks ago. Also, the last Epoch build planner is already updated to 0.9, so this info might change by a little bit, but probably not by much, just warning you. Another thing I'd like to point out, the reason why I kept the build a little unfinished is because I want to give a realistic expectation of what your build should be like after day 1, not after like day 5 or 7 or whatever, where you get through low level monoliths and you're an empowered monolith. So the gear isn't perfect, but this build concept will easily carry you much farther than I showcase in the video, as I've already played this concept to 300 plus corruption on an older video, which will be linked down below. If you end up enjoying this content or learning something new, I'd heavily suggest leaving a like on the video and subscribing to the channel, as that's the best way of telling me that you want more content like this. With that out of the way, we can talk about the fun stuff. Time to dig into the box of fun builds I have to showcase, and the first one is Abyssal Echoes Devouring or Void Knight. We have two reasons to be playing this. First off, Crypt Devouring Orb is kinda dead. With the nerfs to Dark Torrent, which is now named Chaotic Torrent, which is great because of how chaotic the node actually is, this means that Devouring Orb will have a much less consistent time in general. You could still play it, but we have better options now. The second reason why we're playing this is because it has been buffed twice in 0.9 for absolutely no reason, as Abyssal Echoes was a very strong build before this already. So, if you have not played this archetype before, the combo that is under the hood here is the interaction between Abyssal Echoes and any hit source. Abyssal Echoes applies Abyssal Decay on enemies. It is an ailment that can only stack once and deals void damage over time. It scales off your void damage, damage over time, and spell damage. It also gains 2 flat void base damage per point of vitality that you have. Now, normally, this decay does little to no damage per second, but it has an insanely long duration, so you apply it once and it deals a lot of damage over its duration, not just per tick. But if you hit the enemy with any source of hit damage, it will take the rest of the decay and deal all that damage instantly. In endgame, to deal the most amount of single target damage, you need to apply the decay, then remove it with a hit, and then rinse and repeat a lot of times, and that's usually how you set it up. One of the most efficient ways of doing this is through Devouring Orb. Devouring Orb is a spell that creates an orb that will create an explosion when you kill an enemy. You can also specialize it to orbit around you, and then you can also specialize them to shoot at enemies. Recently, with the change to Dark Torrent to Chaotic Torrent, this is a lot less consistent than before, which hurts the crit version a lot more than our version, as we only need to hit the enemy like 3 to 4 times per second, which we can easily achieve with the nerfed version of Devouring Orb, as of course the orbits will hit, and of course as well the little explosions will hit as well. So, in the end, we apply Abyssal Decay, then pop it and remove it with a Devouring Orb hit, whether it's an orbit hit or a hit from the Chaotic Torrent. We rinse and repeat, and that's how we deal all of our damage. When it comes to monster packs and the Monolith of Fate, we only need to do this once, and it feels absolutely wonderful for clear, as you just simply need to cast Devouring Orb off cooldown, which is 6 seconds cooldown normally, then of course you just place an Abyssal Echo under a pack, and bam, they all die. It also has a lot of proliferation built into it, thanks to our skill tree, meaning that it can actually reach about a screen away, which is really, like, about half a screen away, which is really cool. This build has been buffed in 0.9, though, with 2 different nodes. The first one is in Devouring Orb. Void Adept, changing from increased damage to more damage, is huge, as it is global and it will affect our Abyssal Echoes. The mana regen is nice as well, and the requirement of hitting 90 plus vitality is not too hard as a Void Knight. So this is just a free 20% more damage multiplier, as we had a lot of increased damage from our idols and gear, so this is just helping us be more effective per point. The other node that was buffed was Embrace the Darkness. 20% more damage versus blinded enemies is also a huge buff. As I said before, we had plenty of increased damage to go around, and both of these changes mean that we have about 44% more damage in total versus patch 0.8.5. And we had plenty of damage before. This footage is from 0.8.5, which is before the buff. So imagine this, but with 44% more damage. It's going to be great. If you enjoy Crit Devouring Orb and you want to maintain close to the same playstyle, this is the build for you. Sure, you have to actually press buttons, but if you numlock, you weren't really trying to play the most efficiently anyways, now were you? Now, for leveling the build, I have already made a video on leveling, which will be up to date in 0.9. I'll be leaving a link to that down below in the description. I leveled with Holy Trail, with, of course, Lunge and all of that good stuff. But the leveling guide that I'm linking down below will be the more, the shield and one hand focus. Now, with all that being said, let's get in the video, shall we? All right, here we are in game with the build. It's Alekos. It's a solo character that I've been playing on stream for the past few days. So as you can tell, reses aren't perfect, but we are in fact in empowered monoliths. I've been pushing corruption. We're currently at 160 corruption, but sadly I do have a lot of other videos and builds to work on, so we have to end it here. 176, that's plenty for now. This is essentially supposed to represent what you'd have after a day of playing and setting up. So let's talk about the skills, shall we? First skill is Abyssal Echoes. Now, of course, we take 2 points travel into deep expanse, 1 point of Vorpal Explosion, and makes it so that the base version of Abyssal Echoes no longer works, where it's just a circle instead of chaining across a bunch of different places, but that's completely fine for what we're using it for. And of course, we take 1 point into Screaming Rifts. Abyssal Echoes now creates an Abyssal Rift at the target location that casts Abyssal Echoes for you 3 times at its location before expiring. And then, of course, we tag on 2 additional Abyssal Echo casts. The reason why this is so important is because of the fact that we want each single Abyssal Echoes cast to apply multiple Abyssal Decays so that when the Devouring Orb hits the target, right, it will keep, of course, cleansing the target, which is great. So that's why we add so many extra casts with Abyssal Echoes. So it just sits there, keeps applying the decay so that we can keep getting rid of it. And this gets pretty ridiculous once we have multiple of them and we have maximum uptime. Eventually, you'd want to, you know, of course, set up Anomaly instead of this Lunge, but that's for like when you're more invested and have movement speed. Now, 1 point into Spreading Chaos, this makes it so that Abyssal Echoes will spread to nearby enemies. If I apply it into a pack and then it ticks for a second, and then everything will spread after a few seconds. And of course, we have another spread we never enemies to spread to. So it spreads to like 6 enemies in an area, a decently sized area. I could be over here and it could spread all the way over here, which is great because that means that we have extra clear with our Abyssal Echoes. It's not just the circle, which helps enormously for clear. And of course, 1 point travel into Vorpal Reverberation, 2 points travel into Rippling Corrosion. We actually don't care about armor shred at all. 2 points into Tide of Rush travel, and then 1 point into Time Compression. This will remove the cooldown on Abyssal Echoes as it has a 4 second cooldown. Now, you actually don't have to take this node. If you feel like as though you're dealing enough damage, if you feel like as though you don't need to do extra damage and all that, you can take this node out, take these nodes out, add extra Abyssal Decay duration, add like just everything else you could possibly think of with Vorpal Reverberation. You actually don't need this node to function. The reason I really like this node is because if I stack a bunch of Abyssal Echoes and then of course use Reversal, it means I have maximum uptime on my Abyssal Decay stacking and it feels wonderful. But if you don't like that, if you don't like playing with Reversal, simply take this node out, take these 4 nodes out, put them into Turbulence and into Vorpal Reverberation, you can completely ignore that function of the build. So that's really up to you. There are 2 different ways of doing it. Or you could add extra points in Nether Breach, which makes it so each Devouring Orb will also do a Rift, so they'll instantly pop your Abyssal Echo Degen, which is great. So there's a lot of different ways of playing with this, and I suggest that you try other, you know, styles. Then 2 points into Turbulence, and eventually when we get plus levels to Abyssal Echoes, I want to get this to max to +5, so that we get all that juicy duration as it is more damage. Now I have 4 points in Embrace the Darkness. Right now, this is increased damage over time with the buff, but once the patch rolls over, this will be 20% more damage versus blinded enemies. Make sure that you have some blind chance, whether it be in the Paladin Tree, like 2 points in this and your Devouring Orb, so make sure things are blinded. Wherever you can get it, that'll be great. This will just give you 20% more damage. Right now, we're technically wasting points here by putting you in here, because I wanted to replicate what it would feel like after the patch. So yeah, Missile Echo's great. Devouring Orb, it's your TLDR setup, the usual setup, although this node is going to be a Chaotic Torrent, which means less frequent, but the thing is, we don't need that many hits to apply our Abyssal Decay, specifically while clearing, right? So this will be fine. But then this will be turned into, I think, 10% more global void damage and 10% mana regen, and eventually it'll get doubled if we have 90 plus vitality. So this will be another 20% more global void damage. So yeah, Devouring Orb is really good utility skill right now. Feels great. They're also nerfing this node. This is going from 30% cooldown to 18% cooldown per node. So you're not going to be able to spam as many orbs either with this node enabled. So crit Devouring Orb is going to feel really bad. That's why we're playing this version. And of course, sigils, usual void sigil setup, the normal stuff. This is how I would set it up for my build. A lot of other people set it up there this way as well. And this is my setup for Lunge. Right now, Lunge is simply a utility. One of the best things about Lunge over Shield Rush, a lot of people use Shield Rush, which is completely fine, but I think Lunge is superior, mainly because of this node with Dawn Charge. Dawn Charge makes it so we gain 40% of our missing health, which is amazing, as if you're taking damage, you take like 40% of your life, you use Dawn Charge, you can go up almost to max life. This has saved me so many times in boss fights, everything else. Dawn Charge is absolutely amazing. You also get a free 15% kill threshold with your movement skill. Now, eventually, what we can do, once you get enough movement speed, I don't have enough movement speed, once you get LP boots with movement speed on them, with exalted movement speed, we get double silver ring or double well-rolled siphon of anguish. We also grab all the movement speed up here. We get a source of haste. All of that combined would make it so that we could dump our lunge and just move around, which would be fine. And of course, we could go for an anomaly, as anomaly would give us a bunch of extra cooldown recovery speed, some cast speed, and leech. It would make us much tankier. But like I said, the biggest problem is, like, I like the mobility and lunge. So overall, that's just fine. Passives, this will be down in the description, but it's pretty self-explanatory, the usual setup. The Void Knight setup eventually will fill out Eternal Form, and then the last few points we're going to fill out with the last levels we have is Dread. As many points as we get into Dread, and that's perfect. That's exactly what you want for passives. But that's pretty much it for the build overall, I think. I think I'm pretty satisfied with how this went. If you want to learn how to level this build, like I said, there's a link down below. Just level that and then swap over at level 40-ish. You just swap over to level 40-ish, get a Pixel Echo set up with Screaming Rifts. And then as long as you have that and Devouring Orb, you will just demolish the early game like we did on stream the other day. The only unique that I would say that not required, but it's definitely very, very useful, is trying to farm for Atrophies from Rae, Black Sun. Black Sun atrophies are great, as having all that extra pen is wonderful. And eventually as well, I did not get it, but Void Shred as well would be great. Void Shred would be amazing. Yeah, for like the staff here, we have D6 void damage and cast speed. Eventually, when you feel like as though you have enough cast speed, you can definitely go for a double damage staff. Eventually, what you want to do, I had to take this off for the recording because it was OP as hell. But eventually you want like a Titan Heart. I did get this in SSF, sadly. This is kind of like OP as hell. As you can tell, this is a lot of health and stuff. But the base Titan Heart itself, just a base Titan Heart with the 15% less damage taken, and of course 40% increased health, and then a two-handed staff, just make sure that you have adaptive melee damage on the staff. Like, kind of like this, where it says melee physical, except it'd be like melee damage. Because the temple staff does not work for that. Because it doesn't have, like, here you see how it says melee physical. Make sure your staff says melee physical, or it doesn't count as a melee weapon for Titanheart for the 15% less damage taken. But as you can tell, a Titanheart would be great, give us a lot of HP, give us the 15% less damage taken, which is great, makes up for the fact that we're using a Temple Staff or just a staff, and that would be wonderful. And eventually you'd want a Titanheart with Abyssal Decay Duration and Vitality. That would be the best in slot. The rings, just damage, res, belt, cleanse, regen. You need a little bit of regen to make the build feel good. I would say 17, 18 regen would be perfect. Once you reach that, you should have enough regen to make the build feel wonderful. Eventually on the gloves, you can get damage over time and stuff like that. The boots, eventually you want like a LP pair of boots and movement speed on them. Same thing with the relic. Relic doesn't really have anything on it, just res and life. Siphon of Anguish is really strong early on to give you some extra juice, but eventually you could go for like Exalted Silver Rings or something else that is better than a Siphon of Anguish because it's not too important for the build. And of course, the amulet, just res, mana regen, void damage percentage, stuff like that. And eventually we'd want like an Oracle amulet as taking less damage over time. That on top of the Titanheart less damage over time is wonderful for dots. It makes me feel a lot tankier versus poison, which is going to be a problem next batch. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the gearing for the idols. This is like your best in slot idol. This plus a Throne of Ambition. Or you can go for ones with Vitality and Void Damage. Or you can go with ones with Abyssal Decay Duration. Much better roll than what I have here. That would work as well. Yeah, that's pretty much it for everything. With all that being said, this has been Dread. Off to go work on another start.